I blast it on Twitter. We'll play your house for $160. Fans just started being like, me, me, me. I'm done writing. The record is done. And the label was like, oh, well, your record's not coming out till January or something. And I said, well, I'm not gonna sit here and fiddle with my dick for 6 months.
I am not the guy who makes you smile now. But when we talk, it's not the same.
People were like, I'll do a show. Please come to my house. Some people would be like, I'll give you more money to this house.
So I won't cry. No, I will just pretend.
You know, we're behind in the United States as far as, you know, our standing as a band. Selling out real venues is not gonna happen when we're not on album cycle and getting press. And I'll just set up the shows with, you know, people who wanna have us play their house because they're diehard fans.
I am down to six.
I think the biggest difference is that A, like, you don't know what to expect before you get there. You don't know what the money's gonna be. You don't know what the sound system's gonna be.
I have no idea what this is gonna be like. Is this gonna be a disaster?
But I won't cry. No, I will just pretend.
You need as many people to know about your music and be into it as possible. That's how you can keep making it and support yourself from it. I don't think there's anything I love more. There's just things that are conceptually easier to make money at. This right here is actually the vision. They have their own fucking house with nothing in it. And all the food and beer.
Did you feel things out? Did you get responses that people were just like, man, come play the ditch? And you're like, no.
I just put it in challenge terms. I was like, okay. They would respond to me, and then I'd be like, so tell me, what's the deal with this thing?
Okay.
Are you really?
Saw them last year. I had no idea that the dancing thing was a thing. But listening to their songs, I don't think that really comes across. It's like the idea that these three, like, really tall men are gonna start just like totally grooving in the middle of the set.
I feel stupid watching shows a lot. I'm like, should I dance? Should I not dance? I want to dance. I don't want to dance. I feel like if I dance, I'll look stupid. If we go up there and look stupid, then you can feel fine about looking stupid standing there watching it.
Fuck it up for me with all of your depression and anxiety, neck, head down.
Call my baby love. Hey, what's up, girl? We played the show, and these kids letting us crash in their parents' guest house.
Good night.
All right, love you. Good night.
She doesn't say I love you back to me. She doesn't say it back. Not always.
Another new one? This one's about my girlfriend. She doesn't say I love you very much.
Say it fast. Don't just say it back to me. I need words, use your words to love me actively. Act as if you're actually attracted to me.
He's like really into like talking and expressing his love with words, and I'm like the opposite.
But to lock antlers with you. Stare me down.
I feel like that doesn't mean much to me. Like, I feel like I express myself with, like, actions more. But we have different views, and that's fine.
Loving you requires ammunition. Well, can you
listen? It has its own toothbrush that I use to get the hairs out of it.
What the fuck are you talking? That can't be true. You're saying it's an independent toothbrush.
I turned him onto this. This stuff is, I've been using that, it's been working for me.
Why does it do that? It smells like your armpit.
You gotta go 100 times. 1, 2, 3.
And only put it on when your shit is mad clean. Don't put it on when you stinky already, it's not gonna work. And here we have Dr. Bronner's peppermint. That'll really
clean. This just smells like your fucking armpit, dude.
You clean.
Legit, smell that.
But it works though.
Oh, it does.
Smell that. You look cute, you look sweet.
But it's smooth, you ditched me. Once I got like the dots on the map of where we're gonna be playing, I asked my booking agent Ryan to set up some smaller shows for us in major markets that we were gonna be near. So that helped us, you know, not lose so much money.
I feel like no one's gonna come to our Chicago show. Do we? I don't think we have a crash for Chicago either. We need that. I gotta tweet that. When all you say is maybe, yeah.
Started a text and then I closed the screen and I opened it back up. It was.
Yeah, that'll happen. 8 notifications. Nope. Nope. Live by the tweet, die by the tweet. Well, at least we're right here on the poppin' scene.
That's just parking a Walmart.
He sold it out, you guys.
Did he?
Yeah. What a fantastic crowd. Twitter to the rescue.
We did it. We rocked it out.
We rocked it out.
We sold it out.
Sold it out.
Found a crash. Lost the crash.
It out. Lost
found it
out.
Again.
Found out.
Parking.
Parked it out.
Take time to smell the roses, you know? These are music cues that I composed for a commercial, maybe. They were like, oh, make us something sexy and masculine. And I had a blast doing it. This is before I was like inspired to like make the album. I can't believe they didn't use it. A little too shreddy there.
Free show.
Free show. It's like to promote his brother's tattoo shop or something like that.
A comedian and then us.
I think it's gonna be a weird night.
This is the band. We're Darwin D's. We're on tour right now, playing some house shows and some venue shows, and I desperately want him to finish whatever he's doing.
Alright, your turn, Greg.
Woo! Anyone get a tattoo today?
Probably not.
No.
We're going to get with Jason Sanders. Jason Sanders, where you at?
You know? You don't know what's going to happen.
But I'm like, we're fried. We're so
fried too.
Last night we had a room full of 100 fans. Tonight we had 4. And then a child band.
I can't believe they interrupted our show with the raffle. That was surprising. It was cute though.
That was the weirdest fucking show ever. Has there been a weirder show than that before?
I don't know. Probably.
I don't think so. Let's go get burritos.
All right.
There's no way Darwin's gonna be able to do it without cracking up.
So first I asked to speak to the manager.
Are you calling them
now? What are my bullet points? We just played a show.
Telling our fans about you and tweeting about.
Hi, Chipotle. This is Deja. How can I help you?
My band, we're on tour from Brooklyn, and we just played a show here in Plainfield. Some managers at other Chipotle restaurants have been helping us out. In turn, we've been sharing about it with our fans. It's really hard to eat healthy on the road. Just wanted to call and ask, see if that's something. Would you think you can help us out today?
He said it's four of you guys?
Yeah.
Just tell my cashier you're the rock band, and she'll take care of you.
Okay, rock on. Thank you.
Chipotle food. Hey!
Oh, he did it! Oh, it was wordy, but he did it!
You look happier than hell, man.
Well, I ought to be.
I can't, I was so nervous that whole time, man.
Nah. Next stop, Red Lobster.
Brown people, they were like light Mexicans, but it was still warming to my heart.
Yo, what's up with Chipotle? Hey, my name is Darwin. Can I speak to the manager, please?
My plan was like, look, if you want to charge money and whatever, that's cool. I'll tell you what my real story is. But if you want to just have a free show and you want to pay me $160 instead of a PA for me, you can do that.
The thing is, I'm pretty sure they're going to be like, all right, here's $160. They're just going to try to share it among everyone, which is fine.
You didn't shake? You didn't pre-shake?
I mean, I pre-shook them a little.
What's the pre-shakedown look like?
Pre-shakedown is where I say, look, this is how much I personally am spending to do this show. I just say, look, I promise them $150 each. Plus gas. So if you're gonna be making money personally, just know that I'm losing money until I get 400. That's what the shakedown is.
Every time I've agreed to like do a tour, I've never asked like how much you're paying. I find out like once we're already in it, he's like, oh, this is what I can do. He's gonna be fair about it, so I don't really worry. I'm just down to do it.
Everyone, keep your seatbelts fastened and arms inside the ride at all times. We're Howard East from Brooklyn, New York.
I mean, just like these things are at every fridge we've ever been in, you know? And I want to do a mock one so bad. It's just the style, but like something's wrong with it, right? Like a little alien is popping over his shoulder, but it's like professionally done. I just dropped a sausage into my wine. Yeah, I photoshopped like crazy. I did a parody of like Beach Photo with the jump. I did a version of that, and then I photoshopped it so I'm like 15 feet off the ground. And then some people were just like, I need to get up that. Look how fucking high I am. We'll speed this up in post.
Three of us in the touring party today. You think you can help us out?
One of the most fun parts of this tour, I feel, is like is just rolling up and not knowing what it's gonna be like at all.
Yeah, we actually have a lot of fans. I had people DMing me from like two or three towns away, asking if they can come, and I was like, dude, if you're a true fan, you gotta come. Like, of course.
When I was put the initial blast out, which was like, I'll play your house for $160, they were like, yo, I'll double it. And then his brother tweeted at me, he's like, I'll throw in another $160. Oh, so we're talking $480 for me to play Iowa? I guess I gotta say yes to that.
I'm so psyched. Never put on a concert before, so.
Yo,
These guys want to meet you like really bad.
Kyle, you go first. I'm nervous.
No.
Hi, Darwin.
Hi.
I'm Robin.
Hey, man. Nice to meet you.
Oh, god damn. This is Darwin D's right now.
I'm Darwin D's.
It is. Damn, like a real Jesus Christ.
Sometimes people mistakenly think I'm a really good guitar player. I'm not a great guitar player, but I do love it. That's honestly most of the experience of seeing a great guitar player is. That goes for if you're not a guitarist yourself, is that you see them in the zone, and that's fun to watch, and that feels good to watch. If you play a little bit of guitar, but you want to play more, then you have a potential to be excited about my guitar playing. But when we're able to put on a show where people objectively had fun, then I feel like I'm good at what I do.
Just want to like have a moment to myself. Yeah.
That was awesome, man.
In this work.
Hey, thank that you. That was awesome.
Thank you so much.
I feel like I endorsed smoking a little too much on that solo. I was like, this kid, smoking is definitely very cool. I just felt like that kid was a super fan and he would be excited if I did that.
Shit off me.
People are wasted enough that it gets to the light switch, right? They're just gonna be like,
hey, great show, man. You're gonna be like, what? They're gonna be like, fuck you!
So we were gonna play like a very small private
house show.
Somebody else swooped in on Twitter and was like, where's the show? And I was like, ah, it's kind of private, but I'm trying to find somewhere else. And he's like, oh, I got a spot.
So I looked it up, I actually came here yesterday and I drove around and didn't see anything. But I was like, okay, I'm still gonna try it tomorrow. So I was driving around like at 8 o'clock and I saw this guy with a Voltor Pedro shirt. And I was like, oh, are you going to the Darwin D's show? It's actually real. Darwin D's is here.
Honest and like relatable, I guess. So, I don't know, it's like really real, you know?
Darwin D's was one of the first bands my dad was into that like I had been like, yo, like I found this music, like do you wanna like listen to this with me? And he's like, shit is great.
I do a thing a lot of times where I'll take like a metaphor and I'll stretch it out for the whole song.
Yeah.
So like we have that song Getaway, it takes the metaphor of robbing a bank and in the chorus of that is represented the emotion, which is excitement, and it sort of maps that metaphorically onto the exciting feeling you have of like being with somebody. So that's kind of the type of song that I try to write, you know? Yeah, the first Darwin D song I ever wrote, Deep Sea Divers, was like
right.
A concept and an environment that you can latch your mind onto.
You were tired of swimming and so bored. Little yellow fish go past your sullen face.
This is not a love song, basically, is what the way I write it. And you're like, oh, that's interesting. I've never heard a song about deep sea diving. People out here are always writing stupid love songs about love. Then you can settle in and enjoy the environment that the lyrics are creating. And then from that point, you're ready to actually see like, oh, what is this guy feeling? And do I relate to that or not?
His music, like, it was part of my life, honestly, you know? I moved to the United States like 5 months ago. So, my girlfriend, she's Brazilian, and I had to move in January when he says, because you're moving away from me, the universe is only empty space without you, you know? It really got to me. You know when something happens in your life and there's nothing to do about it, you just have to go on and go through with it and accept that whenever those things happen, like those special moments in your life, there's always a song that like kind of like sets it, you know, like it marks the change in your life, and Darwin D's was that for me.
Was there a big bang that I just missed? Was some explosion cause a red shift? Cause you're moving away from me. But what did I do? The universe is mostly empty space.
Take struggling musician over whatever the fuck he just went to go do.
He power washes trucks.
Power washes trucks. Oh my god. I don't really want to get a normal job by any means.
Other people would look at us and be like, oh my god, get it together.
Yes,
like,
for sure.
Also, I definitely worry about retirement. I'm like, every time I try and have like a talk about finances with my girlfriend, I'm like, no, this is really my tax return. This is real. And she's like, this doesn't even make sense.
I had a desk job for 5 years. I was working at like a huge corporate real estate company, but I wore a suit and tie, and wow. I was drunk or hungover every day. It was like 22 to 26 or something. I did that job, frivolously spending on whatever I fucking wanted. But my, you know, mom was like, better keep that job, you know, that's a good job. You know, healthcare, it's all about staying alive, right? All that matters in life is that you keep going. But who gives a shit if I'm miserable the whole time, you know?
Yeah.
Or not that I'm miserable, but I'm just passing the time. I'm just sitting there looking at every site the internet has to offer until the 8 hours is gone. And I can tear the suit off and drink until I can't anymore. How did we get on this conversation?
Well, we're just pretending that it's okay that we're gonna be poor hobos when we're older.
Yeah.
Like, ah, oh, man, in the moment. We're living in the moment.
What's up, guys? We're here in Nashville, Tennessee, playing a house party, getting down and dirty. Burgers and dogs, keg of beer, good people, good vibes. Always have your tech deck. Better go in there with the tech deck out, let the ladies know what the deal is right away.
This song is called The World's Best Kisser.
The world's best kisser is a girl who believes in nothing. She wears a lot of black and isn't very trusting. And the world's best kisser is a girl I know. Since I met her, I'm a metronome.
Because it's such a communal fun space where there's a bunch of people and not just like fans that are kind of ushered out after the show, it tends to always be a party that's happening right there. We were a part of it for that, you know, for that hour and 15 minutes. But as soon as that's done, it's just straight back to the party that was happening before it and is now going to continue happening after.
Writes me lines of code without a mouse.
I think it's been like one of the best experiences I've ever had touring.
Girl, what turns you on? Pages of a book on the elliptical.
We got like enough money to break even, which was way more than I had asked people for at 160. And they let us crash at their house. And they make us breakfast the next morning, which is like the nicest, warmest love fest of a tour that we've ever been on.
You know, my philosophy from when I first started playing music on, you know, in a band was like, I just want to be on the road with my best friends.
I'm never happier than when I'm just playing shows because I'm socially connected with my best friends. I spend so much time around them and they buoy my spirits.
Pages of a book on the elliptical.